Talk about the education. The first statement that I want to make here is this: retirement is not an age. Alright? So if you see, the world has trained us in such a way, right? You study hard and then after you get a job, how long should you work until you retire? This is not biblical, am I right? This is not the way how we should be living. So everyone who is working is waiting for their retirement. So they have set their mind that they will retire at 50. Some set their mind they will retire at 60. Okay, so we can see in different countries, right, the government actually rules the retirement age and so on. But let me make a bold statement tonight that retirement is not an age. So what is retirement all about? When are you supposed to retire? Alright? So the whole idea here is that we want to be able to retire young, retire rich. Can you see that? So how young should you retire? Alright, this is the answer. Now, retirement is when your assets pay for your lifestyle. So this is the biggest question. So when somebody tell you that they want to retire, the question is that, do you have an asset? Do you have an asset that is basically working for you instead you working for money? Your asset is actually working for you. Alright? So asset is basically, okay, basically will begin to give you cash flow. So your asset will take care of your lifestyle. But so many people today, if they lose their job, it is gone, right? They couldn't maintain their lifestyle. They also couldn't maintain their family, their children's education, their own retirement. They couldn't do it. Why? Because these people are only dependent from the conventional or what the world is teaching them, which is the job. That's why most of them are just over broke. Can you see that? So when we hear people saying that they want to retire, like myself, when I decided, okay, I decided many years ago that I want to retire as young as possible, not as old as possible. Can you see that? So the world is thinking about how old the older they are, the much older they can be, they can retire. No, that is not retirement. So what is the point of retiring late and retiring old when you no longer have the strength to enjoy everything that God has given to you? Can you see that? So now, retirement is when your assets pay for your lifestyle. So the biggest question is this: do you have an asset? Alright? So some people say house is an asset. House is not really an asset if you are still paying loan to the bank. So house is a liability. Can you see that? Car is not an asset. A car is also a liability. Can you see that? So now, when you talk about an asset, your asset must be working for you. And it must be growing in value. It must be basically growing in value over time. So that is an asset. So one day, your asset will be paying for your lifestyle. Your asset will be paying for your car. Your asset will be paying for your houses. Can you see that? So you do not need to take a credit facility from the bank, because one day, your asset is going to pay for you everything cash. Now, so the goal is to retire young. Okay, I want you to keep this in your mind. You have to change the way you think tonight. Okay, I want all of you who are listening to me tonight to receive this impartation of the Spirit, these dimensions of the Spirit. Okay, so that you can begin to reconfigure the way you think. Alright, so retirement is not when you are old. You can retire young. You can retire whenever you like. The question is that you can retire young, you can retire rich, but make sure you are retiring with a cash flowing assets. So until you don't have an asset, you cannot retire. So the sooner you have an asset that can actually produce a cash flowing assets, then you can actually decide to retire. Alright, so make sure, okay, this is so important. So the goal is to retire young, retire rich with cash flowing assets with no pension. So you don't have to depend. So some people, right, they are working with the government. So they think that, oh, it is fine. If I will retire, the government will still take care of me. It is no longer the way we used to live, my friend. Alright, the government is not going to take care of you. Can you see that? Some people are dependent on their Y2K and so on, right? They have their own. Some people are dependent on their savings. Let me tell you something. How long will your saving last? Those people who are dependent on saving, they are basically being manipulated by the bank. Do you know what is the interest rate that the bank is paying you? Do you know that the inflation rate is much higher than your interest rate? An inflation rate is a legal way how the government is basically, I want to say, taking advantage of how the government is basically stealing from the people. Let me just make it straightforward. Can you see that? So inflation is a legal way how the government is stealing from the people. Alright? So that is the reason why if you are keep saving money, If you keep saving money, you can see over time, because of the inflation rate, the value of the money that you save in the bank is going to get lesser and lesser over time. So you're going to have a less and less purchasing power. Am I right? Can you see that? The world use the purchasing power as their KPI. Can you see? So all of us are into the world. So we are part of the world system. But tonight we have to change our mind. Okay, it is not the savings that is going to help you, but it is basically the asset that you are holding with you that is going to help you. All right, and make sure that if you want to retire young, retire rich, then you need to make sure you are debt free. Can you see that? So now, this is the assignment. This is our mandate. And I want you to have this kind of strategy in your mind as you are earning more and more, no matter what platform you are in. Alright, so let's take if you are earning Bitcoin. So as you are earning more and more, as the Bitcoin price begin to grow in value over time. So that is your asset. Can you see that? So you are now earning a cash flowing asset. What do you need to do first? Make sure you take care of all your debts. Pay off all your debts. Make sure that it will be your first priority. It can be your debt, it can be your family debt. Make sure you pay off all those debts. Alright, so once you have paid off all the debt, now you're going to have excess money, right? You're going to have excess money where now you can use to build a better future. Can you see that? So that is the most important thing. And this is what I call financial freedom. Financial freedom is not having big cars or big house where you are still in debt. Financial freedom is when you have zero debt and you are still actually earning a cash flowing assets. So the answer is to generate asset-based income. Can you see that? That is the reason why I always emphasize in my presentation, asset-based income. You must look for an asset-based income, okay? So that's the reason why we have this fantastic platform where we can actually earn an asset-based income every single day, right? So make sure you are generating an asset-based income that keeps generating more and more income. This is what I call by multiplication system. Alright, so as you grow your asset, now what you can do, because you are already earning an asset-based income, and because your asset is actually giving you a cash flowing assets or give you more and more cash flow, what should you be doing? Now you can go out there and buy more assets. You can go and possess the land. You can go and buy the land. Land are assets, but you do not need to take loan. You can now pay cash and purchase those possessions from cash. Can you see that? Is that powerful? So this is the way how God has created us to live, because God said, take dominion over everything, right? God didn't say, go and take loan from the bank. No, we do not want to be dependent upon the bank. That's the reason why when you look into the Melchizedek order, when you look into Abraham, when Melchizedek approaches Abraham, okay, and thereafter you saw how King of Sodom came, and King of Sodom began to negotiate, okay, with Abraham. But Abraham said, I'm not going to take your goods. But we have so many Christians today, so-called believers, they are still dependent on the worldly goods. They are still dependent on the bank. They are still dependent on everything. So how can you say that you are basically following the Melchizedek order? Can you see that? So a Melchizedek order means you are only dependent on God. That is it. That's why Abraham realized that God is the possessor of heaven and earth. That is the reason why Abraham gave 10th of all his assets. Can you see that? Abraham did not give his 10% of his salary. Abraham gave 10% of all the assets that he owned. Can any one of us do that? Why? Because Abraham realized that God is the possessor of heaven and earth. Can you see this? So that is the reason why if you become successful, will the bank say it is because of our money that you became successful? Can you see that? That's the reason why I stop people from taking loans. But we have so many preachers, okay, that are still talking about go to the bank and take the SME loans and take the money and take what the world is giving to you. But when you become successful, who will get the credit of that? That's the reason why Abraham refused to take anything that is offered by King of Sodom. Can you see that? Because he is completely dependent on God. So this is so important. So if you build an asset and your asset is generating more income, your income is generating more assets, this is a multiplication system, right? That you need to think. So that's the reason why if you ask me, right, to give you a very, very simple example. Like look at my children. I have two kids. Okay, my son is 11. My daughter is 10. People ask me, do you really save for them in the bank? I don't really save for them in the bank. Now, when you talk about saving, there are two types of saving. One is a spendable saving, okay? And the other is a saving for the future, right? No, I only save spendable money. That's all. I don't save my future in the bank because the bank is not my future. So where do I save, okay, the future of my children? I actually buy Bitcoin and I actually have a wallet for my two kids, and that has been my practice for many, many years. So I do dollar cost averaging every single month, okay? I begin to buy certain amount that I've already fixed and I begin to keep. Now, when I look into their wallet today, I was so shocked to see, no, these are young, they are just 11 and 10 years old, they can already retire. Can you see that? So just imagine when they are ready to go to further their education. Do they need their parents' money? No, they already have the asset. They already have a cash flowing asset in their own wallet. They can basically pursue their own education. Can you see? So the education is going to pay for your lifestyle. Your asset is going to pay for your lifestyle. Your asset is going to pay for your education. Your asset is going to pay for whatever that you need in the future. Can you see that? So this is the way how millionaires should be thinking. All right, that is the reason why when God deal with Isaac, the first thing that Isaac did was to possess the land. Why? Because land was an asset at that period of time, and God gave Isaac grace, okay, to be able to turn around the famine into a fertile ground that he began to flourish. Can you see that? So that is so powerful. This is the reason why we encourage you, okay, to focus on the asset. Now, let's quickly go into one of the most important. Now, if you have an asset, let's take an example. You have a Bitcoin. All right, now, most success, why does most people are not really successful, although they have an asset? Okay, the reason being is very simple. This is the one word, okay, one word that can actually solve the whole mystery. And that is called hold. Okay, holdless. Okay, these are probably, you might be thinking, it shouldn't be spelled in this manner, right? It should be H-O-L-D. No, this is the terms that we use in the crypto space. Okay, so what does holdler means? Holdler means is hold on dear life. Alright, so this is the reason why, okay, any one of us can become a millionaire. The only reason is that you hold on to this asset, to your, like you hold on to your dear life, and you wait until the right time for you to liquidate that asset. Now, this is the problem most people, okay, they are not able to hold because they need the money. Can you see that? That's the reason why every time they have an asset, they go and sell it. And they want kina, they want ringgit, and so on, because they want to spend the money. Now, if you keep spending and you cannot hold to your dear life, then you are not going to realize, okay, the future that you are preparing for you and for your children. So there are few things, okay, that when you talk about hodler over here, one is excess cash, okay? So this is important. So that's the reason why if you are investing into any platform, okay, you must have an excess cash. The money that you put into the platform should not affect your lifestyle or your family. Can you understand me? So that is it. So if you can take this excess cash that you have in your bank account, you can actually place into a platform where you can earn an asset like Bitcoin. So you can just leave that excess cash to grow your portfolio over time. So you will never worry about withdrawals. You will never worry about delays. You will never worry about anything. You will be keep upgrading, keep compounding, because you are going to earn more and more assets. Can you see that? So this is so important. That's why you see the big institution are now going into, because they have an asset. So what do? This is called an asset management risk. Instead of putting their asset into the financial institution, the banks and so on, they diversify the excess cash, and now they are buying Bitcoin. Can you see that? So they are smart because they know exactly what to do. Now, the second is that holding power. This is where most people have the problem. They don't have the power to hold. That's the reason why if you don't have excess cash, then you will not be able to have the power to hold, because you are using the money that you need for every day. All right? No, you can't do that. If you take the money that you need for your lifestyle, then you are not going to have the power to hold, because every time you try to hold, you are tempted to actually sell your Bitcoin because you need to use for your family. Can you see that? So this is the reason why you need to start. You need to make sure you have the excess cash. Okay, so this is the reason why most people, okay, when you talk about the holding power, is a lot has to do with the volatility of the market. Can you see that? So when the Bitcoin price is up, everybody is happy and they want to hold their Bitcoin. But when the Bitcoin price is down, they become sad, and now they think Bitcoin is a scam. Alright, so there is a volatility in any market. Even if you talk about gold, even if you talk about the stock market, there is a volatility risk. That during this volatility, you must have the power to hold. Now, the other thing is that self-control. Okay, this is where many people don't have self-control, because why? They want to keep selling whatever they are earning. They want to convert quickly the asset into liquidate it into cash. Because they are thinking about using that money now. They're always thinking about now. They don't really think about the future. Can you see that? They don't have self-control. You can see again and again, these people are going through financial problem, financial struggle. They are going through lack, okay, because they don't have self-control. So that's the reason why you can't help anyone with money if they don't have self-control. Never help anyone who don't have self-control. Most people who are in credit card debts, their problem is self-control. Their problem is discipline. They are not able to control. Okay, they are not able to control themselves. Come on, my friend. If you don't have a self-control, that simply means you don't even carry the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Because one of the fruit of the Holy Spirit is self-control. Can you see that? So this is when I talk about the self-control, is the liquidation risk, okay? Because they want to liquidate. Every time they are thinking about how to liquidate and spend on themselves and spend on every other thing, all right? So this is the third thing. And the final, okay, the final is the vision. So when you are holding something, okay, when you are holding Bitcoin for your dear life, you must have a vision. What is your strategy? What are you going to do? When are you going to liquidate? To hold forever? That is not the vision. Alright, so you are holding it until 100,000. So let's say, you say, I'm going to hold until $100,000 per Bitcoin. So when it reaches $100,000, I'm going to sell 50% of my asset, and I'm going to take this cash and I'm going to go and buy a business. Or I'm going to go and buy another asset, which is the land. Or I'm going to go and buy a property so that I can convert this property and start to generate more and more cash flowing assets. Can you see that? Now, if you want to have a millionaire mindset, it's always about asset. You are thinking about assets, okay? That is the most important thing. You are not thinking about liabilities. You are not thinking about buying luxuries. No, you are thinking about asset. Anything that you buy, you are thinking, is there a value in this? Can this actually bring more and more value, or more and more cash? That's the reason why, look at the parables of the talents, right? The two who received, they return back to Jesus and they say, Jesus, you give me this talent, now I have actually multiplied it 100%, and now I'm going to return it back to you. Can you see that? That is what God wants us to do. So if you are always thinking about multiplication, if you are thinking about managing what God has given to you as a steward, He entrusted to you, and you start to basically multiply it, and then you return back to God because you know He is the possessor of heaven and earth. That's the reason why you give the 10%, right? Because every time you give the 10% to God, you are telling Him that He is the possessor of heaven and earth. Can you see that? Every time you give the 10%, you are basically, okay, proclaiming in your spirit that God owns everything. that you are not the owner, but you are just the steward. Can you see that? So with that grateful heart, you begin to give to God, because you know that if you give to Him, you are recognizing Him as the owner and also as the provider over your life. Can you see that? So many people don't even know why they are giving 10%. Alright, so now coming back, okay, so you need to have a vision. What is your vision? Alright, so this is so important. So this is your strategic risk, okay, so that you can take action within the next 3 to 5 years. It's going to be an important year for all of us. As Papa began to prophesy and He has given us the prophetic timeline, alright, so it is important that we prepare ourselves. We are saying businesses are failing, economics are failing, but we thank God because we are a child of God. Because in the kingdom of God, there is no recession. So my question to you, are you living in the kingdom or outside the kingdom? If you are worrying, okay, if you are worrying about everyday life and everything that is, you are not in the kingdom. Because if you are in the kingdom, then you are the son of the king. Am I right? A son of the king in the kingdom. A son of the king means you are basically a prince. How should a prince live, my friend? Can you see that? Are we supposed to be begging? Are we supposed to be like an orphan? No, God never created in that manner. Can you see that? He created as a son of a king in the kingdom. So how should we be living as a son of the king? That is the most important thing. So I hope tonight, all right? I hope tonight this has helped you, okay? This has helped you. It's just a quick education because I want to prepare you to be ready, okay? To be ready. So make sure, okay, if you are investing tonight, if you are new, you are listening to me the first time, all right, and you are basically coming into this platform, make sure you have excess cash, okay? Only invest money, all right, that you have excess, that you are actually willing to put, to take care, okay? It shouldn't be affecting your lifestyle, okay? Whatever money that you are putting in, it shouldn't be affecting your lifestyle, it shouldn't be affecting your family. So in this manner, you do not really worry, okay, about withdrawing, delays, and so on. Why are people worrying about delays and so on? Because it is not their excess cash, because they need the money to live every day. Can you see that? So this is so important, okay? And thereafter, the holding power and also the self-control is the most important thing. And finally, you need to have the vision, okay? So